welcome to KPU TV's exclusive coverage of the 2015 Wearable Art Show right here at the Ted Ferry Civic Center. We are a mere moments away from starting, so here we're going to go backstage and see what it takes to put on this show. It is truly an amazing event. An average of 441 people attend every single night, sold out months in advance, and numerous people from around the community participating, so enjoy the program. All right, ladies, amazing eyelashes. Holy smokes. Now, you guys have been working hard for a very long time preparing for this. Give us a clue as to what it took to prepare for this, Alma.
Well, we've been meeting at least twice a week for the last month and a half. The girls had to really coordinate not only dance choreography, but choreography through props, which you'll see later tonight, but it is through sticks, and they had to not only maneuver through the sticks, but maneuver through a small space so that they can emulate being on the stage at the same time.
All right, so what was your favorite part about being part of this, ladies?
Making new friends.
Yeah, very cool, very cool. How about you?
I like dancing. That's the most funnest part.
All right, I gotta know about the eyelashes, though. How do you feel about those?
At first, I was about to cry. Seriously, I got glue in my eye.
All right, so I watched you guys practicing yesterday. Amazing.
Thank you.
You're gonna be in front of a huge crowd. What do you think about that? Are you a little bit nervous? Because you guys perform all the time, and you're totally awesome. What do you think?
It's a little nerve-wracking.
Yeah, just a little, right?
Yeah.
I've done this before, so kind of, but not really.
I've done this so much times, I'm not really nervous.
All right, so how did you get involved in this year's Wearable Arts? And I know you guys are like getting ready to go backstage with makeup and everything else. You're like, oh my gosh, my hair, right? So how did you get involved? Why did you want to participate? What does this mean to your teams?
Well, the reason I got involved, I love the theme of World Beat, and I wanted to incorporate some of my own cultural background into a performance and work with the girls and expose them to different cultures. The music selection infuses tropical with Asian, with down to the American South, and some of, Africa. So I just really wanted the girls to be exposed to that kind of dance as well as give them something fun. The World Beat theme is really up my alley, so I was just excited to apply and hopefully get the opening act, in which we did. So,
all right, very cool, ladies. I can't wait to see you on stage. Have fun.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So, give us a clue as to what's happening back here, because you're clearly manning.
What's happening back here is it's only artists and models allowed, and they're getting ready, and so it's sort of partially organized chaos, more chaos than organized. And so everybody's back here getting ready, and we're supposed to keep everybody else out.
Except for us.
Except for you. Okay. Yeah.
I was going to ask, what are you doing to get ready for tonight? This is a super cool costume.
This is for the librarians.
Nice. And you guys have done that for years and years. You will be totally awesome, though.
All right, so what do you got going on?
Our theme is kind of Egyptian. Mm-hmm. We're looking at the types of readings that was passed on. We've got a cuneiform. We've got scrolls, we've got a book, we've got a tablet, like the modern tablet, and then I've got the phone, I've got the modern day one.
Sweet!
Are these your things, honey?
Do you have your phone? Do you need your phone?
Yeah.
That looks awesome! Yeah. All right, what are you doing?
I'm just getting makeup ready for my costume. I'm Freya, Norse goddess of everything, mostly kitties.
Cool. Okay, and inspiration for your costume?
I'm just modeling it, but it's Norse myth and legends.
Okay, awesome.
You got a lot of hair.
I have. Up I go.
Okay, so we gotta know about the hair.
I haven't gotten a haircut in 5 years. I don't know why, I just said no one day.
Okay, so inspiration for your costume, man?
Braveheart. Freedom!
Awesome, that totally rocks.
Yeah.
All right, kiddos. Super duper duper cool. All right, what made you think this whole thing up? I mean, these rock.
Well, I don't know. They just, my auntie made these for us, and she makes them her costumes every year. But she is very, like, I don't know how she thinks of this kind of stuff, because I would never think of it, but it's, yeah.
So how old are you, and how long have you been in wearable arts?
I'm 12, and she's 13, and I've been in wearable arts for 6 years, and she's been in it for 3.
All right, very cool.
Hello again, everyone. It's time. Are you excited? All right, this is the 29th annual Wearable Art Show. Do you guys know where the first Wearable Art Show was? Where? What? It was Ketchikan. Ketchikan is the first Wearable Art Show. Yes? I think we owe ourselves a round of applause for that. Yes, right here in this town, Ketchikan, with the help of the Arts Council and some really fabulous volunteers, put together the first wearable art show in Alaska. It is now all over the state of Alaska, and it's modeled after this wearable art show. So Ketchikan is cool. But it takes a village to make a wearable art show, so we have a few thank yous. Oh, I should introduce myself. My name is Kathleen Light. I am the director of the Arts Council, and I want to thank you for coming to this show. You're going to have a blast. Okay, back to thank yous. First of all, we want to thank our sponsor since 2009, Wells Fargo. They helped make this happen. They're great partners in the arts. Please give them a round of applause. We couldn't do the Wearable Art Show without the Wearable Committee, and I forgot to thank them last night, so I'm thanking them twice tonight. Two thank yous to the Wearable Art Committee. That committee puts together all of the volunteers, they put together the script, they help figure out the lineup, they do an enormous amount of planning with us, and we love them very much. Please give them a huge round of applause. I think a bigger, thunderous applause. Thank you, they deserve that. They work very hard. You know, the other people that work really hard are the artists and models. Some of them have been working for an entire year on their piece, and they are so excited to show them to you. Let's have a pre-round of applause for those guys. This is definitely thunderous. Okay, there's a couple other people that make this happen. We could not do this without the help of the First City Players tech team. Those guys are awesome. They help throughout the community with any arts event. They jump in both feet, and they're very generous, and we thank them so much. So thank you very much to Chad Chattenbeck up there on the lights and Keith Smith over there on the lights. They are awesome. A big round of applause for those guys. Okay, and I want to thank Teresa, because you wouldn't be able to hear anything without Teresa Wojcik. She does sound all over the community for everything. Thank you, Teresa. Spinning the tunes back there for you is Scott Boland. He does an awesome job. Thank you, Scott. Our wonderful set was created by Steve Villano. And Steve and Amy are new in this town, and I said this last night, and I'll say it again, they are possibly the kindest souls I have ever met. So if you get a chance to meet Steve and Amy, please welcome them to our community, and thanks, Steve, for our great set. We have a pair of Elizabeths to thank, Elizabeth Nelson and Elizabeth Avila, and they both helped our models with movement down this runway. This is a pretty daunting thing that these models and artists do, wearable art. And so both the Elizabeths helped our models go up and down the stage and present this performance for you. Please give them a round of applause. Okay, we have two awesome MCs for you tonight, Claire Bennett and Alonzo Escalante. But before we get to them, we get to watch an opening act. And this year, it isn't just an opening act, it's an opening extravaganza. So I mentioned our wearable committee a minute ago. The wearable committee asks for applications for the opening act from the community. And the application this year that stood out was from Studio Max. And so we selected them to perform our opening act. So using musical influences from the tropical islands of Asia, Africa, and the good old American South, the Studio Max dancers bring you an opening act full of world beats. The performance was choreographed by Alma Parker and the dance team. Tonight, these dancers will be emulating the tinikling cultural dance, which stems from the Philippines. The tinikling is one of the most popular and well-known traditional Filipino dances, involving two people beating, tapping, and sliding bamboo poles against each other in coordination with one or more dancers who steps over and in between the poles during a choreographed routine. The name is a reference to tropical birds called tikling, and the dancers imitate the birds as it walks through grass stems, running over branches, and dodging bamboo traps that rice farmers set. The performers have handmade their colorful beaks, and the costumes they're wearing are portraying birds from around the world. Studio Max would like to thank Dawn Rowell for her artistic expertise in beak making, and Deja Colleen for helping with dance making and costumes. This performance could not be possible without all of their parents and all of that volunteer time. So here we go. We present to you Studio Max and Feet Beat. Thank you.
noches Ketchikan.
Chicago.
Tonight you will. It is Wearable 2015.
And in honor of our theme, World Beat, we wanted to greet you in as many languages as we could squeeze in. Granted that there are 2,976 plus spoken in the world. But anyway, we're excited to see the beat and watch how it is interpreted around the world.
Are you ready, Ketchikan? Let's hear it.
Elementary rhythms. Good gracious, what will these kids think up next? Here, the wearable artists of the Tongass School of Arts and Sciences present a different note or two and are accompanied by surprising percussion.
Elementary to their first wearable art show. They are inspired by the world's cultures and continents. Here they get to show off their creativity and personal spirits.
Little Mermaid. This sparkly mermaid ensemble was inspired by artist model Avika Arnson's favorite wearable arts master, Ivy Rose. This piece is from the artist's beautiful mind that loves beads, sequins, and anything sparkly, My Little Mermaid. Her home and her environment were the inspirations for artist and model Evie Posey. Evie's dress is her own iron-on applique artwork, choosing to portray the creatures in nature's beat. Charter school beatniks. Beatniks changed the way we viewed our culture, and these charter school artists continue with that hipster renewal. Rainbows, music, color, water, and flags all come under scrutiny by their cool cat eyes. You dig it?
looking at.
South Africa meets Canada. South Africa may be far away from Canada, but here in Ketchikan, the two countries are closer than ever. Models Emily and Brandon have been keeping a world beat by constantly sharing their two eccentric but similar lifestyles. The two are inseparable, mainly because they offer each other completion and a friendship that thrives off of spending and gossiping. Slip. Did you ever miss the class bell by just that little bit? If so, you weren't trying hard enough. Here we see 191 tardy slips representing 4,687 minutes of lost learning in a single classroom in a single year. Thank you. Childhood Fantasy. Artist Jan Jorgensen asks, what makes your child's world beat? Is it Legos, dinosaurs, or maybe a really cool ceiling fan? Composed of 61 ceiling fan blades and modeled by his aunt, Jennifer Carlick, Childhood Fantasy is inspired by a 3-year-old boy who just can't stop looking up.
Jetsam, Metacarcinus Magister, inspired Gwen Martin. What's that, you ask? The Dungeness Crab. Her models, Hannah Martin and Cassie Pinnell, wear crab-like armor to live amidst the rocks, barnacles, and savagery of the ocean as the world's current beats over them. We'll be right back.
wings and things. Jill and Aspen have been inspired by the creatures of the world that need to beat their wings. The artists have created their costumes out of fabric, feathers, ribbon, and wire.
Minari moves. Our next model, Lita, is a Rotary Exchange student from Indonesia, and her costume is inspired by ceremonial dress from her home. Artist Marna Sessnan helped Lita assemble her headdress and skirt with a little twist of imagination. Wings are not only heard on all seven continents, but allow birds to circumnavigate the globe, borne aloft year after year. This piece, created and modeled by Bella Posey, is to capture the wonderful feeling of flight. whole Creole soul. This next piece was born of a traditional Southern Creole spark. The colorful outfit contains nearly 1,200 tea packages, accessorized with rope, a driftwood staff, and an alligator made of floats. It all adds a little bayou flair, with Shelly Sidoris modeling her dreams.
Mythology. Corvus Corvax, the raven, figures prominently in the legends of many cultures. In Norse mythology, two of these highly intelligent birds fly each day over the whole world in order to keep the gods informed of earthly events. Here, the god Odin, accompanied by the goddess of love and war, Freyja, survey a battlefield to select valiant warriors to join them in Asgard. The ravens, Hugin, thought, and Munin, memory, return to report the news of the day and to allay Odin's fears that they will not come back.
paper geisha, highlighting the fashion of the exotic geisha and apprentice Maiko, artist and model Bianca Jerzak presents hundreds of paint samples in her kimono, obi, fans, Shimada hairstyle, and Kanzashi hair ornaments. By the sea, things that seem negligible in everyday activities ascend into a higher state, while a certain crustiness and distinct briny odor is acquired. Your electrical wiring is a lot more interesting once it gets a coat of barnacles. Seafaring objects have been revisited with spray paint, wire, and beads to show that new purpose can come from being cast away. Couture. Here we have a tribute to the joy of traveling the world. But what to do with all the things that get shoved into the suitcase while on the road? Artists Tiffany and Sherry Davis spent the winter weaving maps, brochures, ticket stubs, shopping bags, satin and zippers into a walking tour book.
Thank you.
an eye makes the whole world blind. Factional war, religious war, political war, gender war, racial war, war period. Artist Susan Walsh directs our attention to global militarization and the fact that there is an alternative.
Continental drumming. Jesse, no stranger to our stage, has once again used a marvelous sense of color and movement to celebrate this year's theme, World Beat. She brings the drums of the seven continents. Bang on, Jesse.
international models. Come with me now as we dance down the runway with negative impact, fancy flags, and maps of flutter. International models will dazzle you with their creativity. With every step, you will see places of wanderlust you wish to be.
Tells us that this is her interpretation of the Norse goddess Freya, who was the original cat lady. Her chariot was pulled by two cute kitties as she welcomed fallen warriors to her meadow. Folkvanger. Here we see Kirsten Baltz, Megan Peterson, and Kelly Moore in Gold. Kiss, kiss. Devices, our pop warrior leaves behind the old technology and emerges into a digital world of ones and zeros, where every song ever created lives in a cloud of sound. CDs, cassettes, reel-to-reel tape, and reels and records were used to remind us that the method may change, but the music remains.
Thank you.
artist Jackie Kaiser used chopsticks and Kikkoman soy sauce cans she's been collecting for 16 years. And Joss paper her daughter brought back from China to create chop soy. Modeled by Nicole and Corey Embry, this tribute to the Far East is completely, stylistically inaccurate. But hopefully, we'll capture the Asian flavor and won't leave you hungry in the hour.
Genres together. If fusing over 500 grocery bags with an iron counts, then she has achieved world beat fusion. She was inspired by her niece, Clara, and her spunky friends, Kinsey and Jamhana, to create this piece titled Short Fuse.
Thank you.
the Librarians of Alexandria. Such was the prestige of the Egyptian port of Alexandria that Diodorus Siculus in the first century BCE described her as the first city of the civilized world. Alaska's first city also has a library system of which to be proud. Technology advances as sure as love for the written word remains constant. Here are some of your librarians honoring their past while helping Ketchikan keep up with the future. Domination. Men are from Mars, women from Venus. And that's what comes to mind when looking at this piece, a futuristic interpretation of a Venus flytrap melded with a Terminator. Artist Rhonda Green and her minions are here to conquer the world.
Yeah.
Valley of the Kings. The world beat can be heard from the ancient deserts of Egypt in this creation by artist Susan Heiser. Samantha Wodehouse portrays the boy king, Tutankhamun, or simply King Tut. Her dad, Russell, portrays Tut's ancient father, the pharaoh. The goddesses that grace their kingdom are Jesse Minshall, Eskemet, goddess of fire, war, and vengeance. Chelsea Goucher is Hathor, goddess of love, beauty, joy, and music.
Brazilian bird. Brazil takes flight with Madison Ivy's eye-catching parrot. Her colorful design represents the beauty of Rio's world beat and elegant birds in Brazilian bird. Thank you.
Flower Cage. Terry White and Jill Walker model their work Free From Our Cage. The world beat is fast-paced, full of cages, and sometimes we just need eleganza to set us free.
Travesty. And now, Terry Robbins will delight us with her use of fabric, wire, and feathers to express her interpretation of this year's theme.
I want to thank the pageant for allowing me to participate, and if I am crowned, I will use my year to promote your theme of world peace.
Terry, this isn't a pageant. And this year's theme is world beat, not world peace.
Oh, well, that's okay, because green really isn't my color.
Represents a maiden who was transformed into a nightbird for wrongdoings in a previous life. As punishment, she was reborn as an owl, sent to protect the gardens of life and children of youth for all of her immortal days. As she flies, she can finally see all the fire and wrongs around her.
Unstoppable. Elizabeth Avila conquers the stage as Hela, Nordic Viking, queen of the underworld, while Jess Berto, Morahan, the Irish goddess associated with war and death. She's the queen of phantoms, demons, shapeshifters, and witches. Artist Susan Heisler has brought these goddesses to life as the beat of the underworld proves to be unstoppable.
We'll be right back.
Aphrodisiac. A splash of cultures and colors collide, marrying materials from Africa, Asia, and Latin America together to bring this vibrant, wearable art to life.
Spun into a vortex of pulpy, earthy, vibrant redness. Rich in nutrients, sweet and tasty. Beets are perfect. Barb Morgan used hand-dyed cotton, linen, and hemp fabrics to spin up in a froth of color. She is from the beet tribe and has come to whirl joy into your lives. Things, including creating the magic that you see here tonight. So in addition to thanking, of course, the artists and the models and all of the volunteers who are working the lights and the sound and other magical things happening backstage that you don't even know about, I want to take just a second to have us all thank Wells Fargo, who has been a sponsor of this event since 2009. And And just a quick reminder, vote often.
Lucinda, in memory of Ramona Ferry, Diane Palmer tells us, my piece is a tribute to Ramona Ferry, who passed away last year. Ramona gave me her collection of Cracker Jack prizes to make her something. So, here it is, Ramona.
Conquest. Artist Anne Freshley tells us that each model represents an advantage or condition of conquering civilizations in the quest to invade and claim possessions. Guns, germs, and steel determined the course of world history and created our global map. We'll be right back.
Measured beats. The artist, Jackie Kaiser, made this from leftover paper rulers and protractors used for the Alaska State graduation exam. She also threw in some tape measures marketed as diet aids. They are just her way of saying, don't worry so much about test scores and dress sizes. Stop beating yourself up and listen to the beat instead. Does this dress make my base look big? I hope so.
Fighting Irish, decked out in the colors of the Republic of Ira, representing their heritage. Lauren, Ruby, and Riley McHugh make up MC Cubed. We'll be right back.
ancient sea monsters of the seven seas. Using her dad's tomato cages, wire, poles, fencing, umbrellas, and paper, Holly Kanoyer reminds us with the words of Garrison Keillor, "But faith will see you through. What else in such a cynical, corrupt time?" Monsters of the seven seas lie dormant, waiting, knowing that their time will come round again. Stay strong, people and monsters of the seven seas, and be true to yourself. Let's see it again. Muchísimas gracias, Ketchikan. Bon nuit. Gracias por su apoyo y todo su amor.
if we go through.